Hello everyone, this is Badger here for Vadim M, and today we're going to show you a mysterious removed mission, which has been found and restored from the recently leaked mission source files. Special thanks for that goes to the unique and talented people from Grove Street Games, who not only had no freaking clue how to make good remasters of our beloved games, but also didn't look through the game files and remove internal studio files before releasing this masterpiece. But how can we blame them? Thanks to this, we got our hands on the secret mission sources that were never meant to be shown or shared outside of the Rockstar Studios, which for a lot of us is like striking gold. If you are a hardcore fan, then you'll be pleased to lurk through tons of goofy notes, presumably left by Rockstar North employees in 2002. Did you know that they called rival taxis evil taxis in the mission Cabmageddon? I didn't. How about some other mysteries? Well-stacked pizza was internally called Pizza Hut, after the famous franchise from real life. And this is strange because we always thought the place was a reference to Domino's Pizza. First, the name itself partly refers to the stacking nature of Domino's. Second, both of these places use dotted logos. Maybe they had other plans for the pizza parlor. Who knows? But what's more important is that we can finally look at the code and compile it with unused and removed parts in it. Among these not-so-secret-anymore files, there is a unique and mysterious source called Moviedemo. The name probably stands for Movie Demonstration. However, in the code, the mission name appears to be 4X's. To be honest, it doesn't even look like a mission. It's more like a long and weird cutscene. Let's take a look at it. The action starts off in the Washington Beach police station where Tommy is being released from custody. Unfortunately, we don't know the story of how he ended up there. There's a Banshee parked near the police station with a female driver inside. Very slowly, Tommy is going to take a shotgun into this luxurious sports car. Unfortunately, all this time, Tommy was being watched by these two goons and a sentinel from a distance. Right now, they're just observing the situation. Now, as soon as Tommy and that woman drive away from the police station, these followers get on their tail. It seems that eventually, Tommy and the driver notice that something isn't right, and they make a sharp left turn heading into an alleyway and speeding up. The guys in the Sentinel do the same, and now it's a car chase. A few moments later, we see that our protagonists can't lose this tail, driving far away from the place that we saw in the previous shot. How are they going to solve this problem? Well, they manage to drive to the Malibu Club, and as soon as the Banshee stops nearby, Tommy bails from the car and runs with his shotgun towards the club's entrance. The guys chase after him inside with micro-SMGs. While the pursuers take cover behind the railings, Tommy is going deeper in the club, running to the staircase leading him to the second floor. It seems that the target was the club manager, who didn't even stand a chance against the shotgun slugs. Then Tommy runs away. Returning back to the ground floor, Tommy is then greeted with a gunfight. In order to clear a path towards the exit, he starts using his rifle. Sadly, the story did not mention where he got this weapon. That's quite a plot hole. After dealing with his pursuers and for some reason with an ordinary bartender, he leaves the club behind and returns to the Banshee with the driver still waiting for him outside. Sadly for them, they have a new problem now. They gotta get rid of those pesky cops, who've been waiting for them in an ambush, of course. While they manage to avoid crashing into a car that was parked in a very strange place, the driver suddenly oversteers and crashes right into the explosive barrels. And this is how the story ends. No happy endings here. Tommy and that woman were both wasted. What you just watched and heard me describe was a very strange removed mission. If you could even call it a mission, it was more like a weird cutscene with a half-baked story. What was the point of this? According to the mission source, almost every single object or actor used in the code has the prefix movie in their name. Here we have movie cop and movie player, who is Tommy, movie shoppers, movie club manager, and so on. And let's not forget that this source is named Movie Demonstration. How can we tie this mess into the lore of the game? You know what? I actually have an idea. During the story, we can buy the InterGlobal film studios on Prawn Island. After that, we can work for Steve Scott, who's a movie producer there. Of course, all Steve does during the story is make some weird adult movies, and we're stuck helping him with that. This, of course, lets us profit off this property once his missions are over, and even the names of the sources are referring to what these missions are about. However, if we were to explore the studio grounds, you can find a mock-up of Bedford Point from Staunton Island in GTA 3. There's even this movie set for the moon landing with the American flag and a lunar module. And let's not forget about the set with the battleship. These film sets don't seem to be related to any of the adult movies that Steve was making. So what if, in the game, we were filming a movie where we played the main role, and the movie demo mission was our end result? This doesn't actually seem too far-fetched because the developers had something similar in mind. The evidence for that being this removed phone call from Steve, which, according to the sources, occurred after the second mission for the studio, where we had to fly around town and distribute flyers of our upcoming film. Thanks to the leaked sources, we can easily re-enable this phone conversation in the game. Take a listen.
Tommy, look, I need to ask you a favor.
Steve, how's filming going?
Oh, it's going fine, yeah. We need a car chase scene, and, well, the budget can't really stretch to it, so, I've left some wheels at the airport. You know what to do, huh?
Okay, Steve, I'll keep an eye out. Catch you later.
Turns out Steve doesn't just produce adult movies, but some action movies, too. The evidence being this stunt mission, as the developers referred to it as. It was mentioned only in this removed phone conversation and nowhere else. What's more interesting, the in-game subtitles didn't correspond to what Steve actually said. Instead of saying he left some wheels around town, he actually said he left them at the airport. This change to a specific location changes the whole concept of that mission. But I bet this conversation was scrapped early on, since no one even optimized the subtitle timings. They change way too fast. So, the question remains, is this movie demo a part of a movie that Steve was filming? Sadly, this will remain unknown. And you're probably wondering, was the movie demo really made by Rockstar North in 2002 and not by someone else at a later point in time? Yes, I'm 99% sure of this. You see, the code from this exact mission is pretty old. In most cases, it doesn't even work right in the final game. Not to mention that some opcodes used in the mission code are either missing from the game or are named differently. In order to make this mission work, I had to manually fix the code so you could see this masterpiece with your own eyes. Want more proof? First of all, the developers wanted to implement a so-called spline camera, a 3D camera tied to a specific path moving in a space. It seems that the developers wanted to go more cinematic here, showing us the juice of that chase with a flying camera, and not by showing us these boring fixed camera angles that you saw in the footage. Sadly for us, those spline camera opcodes were cut from the game, but the data file, which probably stored the coordinates for this camera, was possibly named after Chris Rothwell, one of Rockstar North's developers who was a mission designer in this game. If I guessed correctly, then the full name of this file might mean Chris Test Environment. Secondly, there is no such shotgun with the generic name of shotgun in the final game, which the mission tries to load. However, it is present in GTA 3, the previous game in the series. As a result, I'm not sure if Tommy used something similar to a Spaz 12 or what the developers called the Chrome Gun at the time. If they reused the police helicopter from GTA 3, why not the shotgun too? Later, they would have redone both anyway. Thirdly, the mission doesn't support the loading of any interiors. As a result, in some scenes you see that Tommy is either walking in air or is trying to pass through closed doors. It seems that the mission was developed when the interiors were still part of the main map and were presumably available at any time. Just another scrapped feature that was originally in GTA 3. Fourthly, some coordinates used in this mission are broken now. It seems that some areas have changed since then, and now the actors either go in circles or try to go through solid obstacles. All of these facts might mean that this mission was developed while the game was still in early development, and it was later abandoned at some point. Because how else can you explain that almost all male actors used in this mission used the same model by the name of Male 01? I'm not sure if this is connected, but this specific pedestrian is one of three pedestrians which is loaded first in the game. The other two are the taxi driver and the cop. Also, the code is very clunky and doesn't seem to be very polished. Any random event occurring can easily screw up the scene, and you run the chance of actually freezing the mission. The footage I showed was made from four separate runs, that's how bad this is. Also, the cops and explosive barrels used in the final part of the mission are the only objects that don't have a movie prefix in their names. It could possibly mean that they had to end the final chase spontaneously, and this part could have even been made by another scripter who had his own approach of naming variables after abandoning it completely. It's so strange that this source survived through all these years, showing us that a lot of effort was put into it, but then it was scrapped. Though it may not have been gone for good. If you completed GTA Vice City stories, then you probably remember the mission the Mugshot Longshot, where you had to drive to the same police station in Washington Beach. Upon arriving at the destination, you'll see Jerry leaving the police station, where he then takes a seat in a VCPD cheetah. Our mission here is to photograph him meeting with a DEA agent, and when it's done, you gotta stay on their tail and see where they're going. Does this look familiar to you? At least that specific part of the mission? This is either a huge freaking coincidence, or this mission could have been inspired by this old and scrapped movie demo mission. The cut stunt mission from Steve could have been re-implemented in Vice City Stories too. In the mission Accidents Will Happen, Rennie, the film director at InterGlobal Films, is making a commercial featuring wild driving scenes with stunts. Unfortunately for Rennie, the old stunt driver quit, so we need to replace him and keep the action meter high by driving recklessly, jumping from the ramps, crashing into stunt cars, and of course crashing into the building in the last scene. At least this crash has a happy ending. What if this mission was inspired by the cut stunt mission from Vice City too? What if the movie demo mission we got was indeed the end result of our hard work for Steve in GTA Vice City? Too bad we'll never know the answer. For more videos related to Grand Theft Auto and Rockstar Games, be sure to check out my channel here on YouTube, BadgerGoodger. And don't forget to follow Vadim and I on Twitter. This has been Badger here for Vadim M, and I hope you have a great rest of your day out there.